Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Gaming with Killer Tia. Getting the review out has been a little bit difficult because, for some reason, my capture card wasn't really cooperating for some reason with this game. But I got some footage here, and we're talking about Paint the Town Red. As some of you may have recalled, we checked this game out back at PAX Online East 2021. And now I got a chance to play the game, and my opinion, it's a pretty decent game. Now, it's not one of those games that you can play for hours on end. It's more like a therapeutic game where you can play for like 30 minutes or so and, you know, just kind of kick back and just relax at all the carnage you are doing here. Now, there isn't much to the gameplay here. You just basically go around beating up people with either your fists, your legs, or even items you find on the ground. You know, it's still not much of the gameplay, but it is solid. And the graphics themselves, I do enjoy them. Frame rate ones that are a reasonable frame rate. And I just love how the blood gushes all over the place. Almost like you're painting the town red. I would have to say it does, for whatever reason, make me a little bit nauseous for some reason. That's also part of the reason why it took me a little bit while to get to the VR, because, even watching the gameplay first, I'm sorry if you know, not motion sickness, but definitely some sort of queasiness. I don't know why. Still, I did what I could to power through this unusual queasiness to get you this, gameplay footage here. Like, as I said before, this is the main gameplay mode here. It's something you only want to play for like in show post at more of a therapeutic thing, not like a hour-long session. But if you are looking for something that's a little bit more depth, they do have another gameplay mode called Beneath. Beneath is definitely a much more fulfilling gameplay mode than the main mode. Not only are there a lot more enemy varieties, but you also have different classes to play around with. For this playthrough, I was playing as the Brawler, but there are a few other classes with their own unique abilities as well. And also, the many different areas of Beneath are definitely a lot bigger and much more intriguing than the different stages in the main mode. And then lastly, there is the arena mode. There are two different gameplay modes with the arena. The endless mode, which you're watching right here, but it's basically surviving as long as you can against the enemies. And then survival, which is basically kind of like endless mode, except it's all broken up in waves. It's definitely not as in-depth as Beneath, but definitely a lot more going on than in the main gameplay mode. Definitely something to play if you're looking for a challenge. Paint the Town Red is definitely not a bad game. The gameplay in the main mode isn't all that crack up to be, but Beneath and Survival mode makes up for it. The graphics are fine, the controls, they're fine, as well as the music. The enemies and the AI, I would say, is a little bit on the difficult side, but that's not a real deal breaker, in all honesty. As I mentioned before, the only real issue I have is, for some reason, hit Paint the Town Red. That makes me feel a little crazy for some reason, and I just don't know why. Honestly, the game is probably best played in short bursts and not like for hours on end. So yeah, definitely pick it up if you only want to play for a little bit at a time. Anyway, this is the Killer Tia signing off. Hope to see you next time.